Operations report. Submarines detected. Crash on landing. Repairs incomplete. Repairs complete. Detection. Sighting. Sighting. Kill credit. Kill credit. Supplies and men move by air. Repairs complete. Repairs incomplete. Ooh, what are all these guys? Are they recovered or are they injured pilots? Or I don't remember these guys being reassigned. Maybe they're from the submarine guys. Like, okay, well, you look at this and say, well, what are they? Are they ship captains? Are they ground combat captains? Are they pilots? What are they? Who knows? Checking for collisions. No collisions. Submarine check. Only two damaged submarines. Okay, both are heading back. No. Sea Leopard. We need to give them the order. Checking on endurance. Wrong kill. Sea Fox, I think, needs to be recalled. Yep. Of course, doing it manually is just so much fun every time. Tigrante is already return. Oh, no. Clear it. And back. Nobody else. Working furiously to repair at Naha. Nothing ready to go at Manila. We have nothing ready to go. That's being damaged. Tenosa is the only one ready for action. Good skipper, out you go. Shikoku Station. Seven sub still under repair at Manila. Singapore, three ships detected. I better make sure we have some escorts going. Right? These guys are recovering from fatigue. Well, while they recover, let's leave them at a range of, is it five or six, the dive bombers are flying. They're flying range of five. Well, we're on naval search, so they won't attack. They might plink a ship, but they're not going to launch a complete attack, so that's all right. We'll leave these guys. Either way, we should be able to recover from fatigue. Let's go. Naval attack. At Manila, a couple of tanker convoys have arrived. Oh, let's dock. Dock and unload. Oh, already unloading? Okay, let's transfer the AO into the... We don't want to suck up the AO. We do want to take the other tankers. We'll put them here. Set for Los Angeles. Of course we don't have enough. Let's do a minimal. Two, three, click it off. Return to Los Angeles. Usual waypoints here. And there. On Luzon, we're trying to hurry through a few more constructions, build up a couple of ports and facilities, because we have so many damned engineers here trying to max these guys out. And then we'll head over to Manila to greet the returning ships. Maybe we can load and get the hell out of here. Get on to Japan. Building these things, building these stupid bases are worth, what, 1 or 2 points each? Building bases on Japan are worth 50 to 100 points each level. So we're wasting time here. Apari, just resting everyone. Oh, here's the night fighter. Let's get him back. Let's get him up to join his mates on Kagoshima. We're still resting, still putting a few supplies, a little bit at a time, up on Baton Island. Naha, the same. We're still unloading. Oh, hold on. Yeah, unloading. Takes a little while. We don't have as many resources as Kanoya. So we got 2/3 done in one day. That's pretty darn good. Pretty darn good. And 3/4 done for the supplies. So we're going to be looking at pulling out the engineering units. I think I'm going to pull the combat engineers as well. When I pull the combat engineers, that's going to mean I'm going to fall below the garrison level of 200. So I'm going to be giving up points, but I want those combat engineers out of here because they're so damned effective. I need them to take down the... So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab some unit back from Kanoya, and we're going to switch them out. Even though, well, while we're switching, we're going to take the penalty for having... we're going to lose 2 or 3 victory points due to insufficient garrison. That's life. I'd rather give up the 3 and take the combat engineers than leave them stranded here. I put a bunch of night fighters, shuffling them over to Apari, letting them rest here, waiting for that moment to jump all the way to Japan. Tiger Cats. We've added all we're going to add. They're recovering. Let's see, pilots-wise, they're learning. They're still learning. Haven't had an opportunity to send them forward yet. Okinawa, as I showed earlier, we're unloading like crazy. There's only 27,000 left on supply here and 49,000 left here, so it should be done in one day. Right, next day we'll reload the combat engineers, take them out. Gotta show this. At Kanoya, oh my god, look at it. Every single ship is empty. Okay. There's a couple of... These are the pissant fuel points that we had before. I'm just going to cancel all these. Do not unload. It's simply amazing. Simply amazing. Because we were only one hex away, I guess we arrived with plenty of time and operational points available. So we unloaded all of it. Everything. Got to make sure all of these are stopped, or else it'll act as an anchor. The other ones will try to sail away, but we won't be able to because one of these stupid things here is still unloading. So I'm just glad I don't have to go through each and every miserable task force here unloading it. We're all done. So we turn off the unload, and we can leave if we want, but we're not going to do that. Okay, here's the 9100. Stop. Oh, here's the AOs. We don't want the AOs to unload, right? So I'm going to transfer them into the dock, into the base. And we're going to turn off these, so we don't want this pissant. Oh, hold on. There's a little bit more than that. No, look at all that. Look at all that crap. See, that's what eats up all the time, loading and unloading this garbage. There's another one. Stop it. And last one here. Stop. Nope, another one. Okay, so what I'm going to do on this last one, let's take a look at what's actually unloaded. Here's a damaged ship, cutter, patrol frigate, and the cargo. Now, we're all keyed upon Task Force 61. Everyone's following Task Force 61. So we're ready to leave now. On the base, we have, look at all that. Not only did we unloaded 7 million points. Well, not 7. There was 70,000 or something like that here already. So we unloaded 6,200,000 points in a day. Just the power of having a naval support, and I don't know what happens with the assault troop transports, but they're all here. All the little land LCIs and everything else. I think that might have contributed. Everyone unloaded. Everyone. 6 million plus. 9,000 in, or say 6 or 7,000 in assault value. That's all the troops and everything unloaded in one day. Staggering amount. Staggering amount. Right, now we need on Okinawa, we have approximately 315 assault value, and we need a garrison of 200. So 315 it means we can take out 115 or so. But we have to replace it. So we have, here's 20, 30, 40, 50, 64 or so. That means we need a garrison of about 135, maybe 140 to go over. Let's see, what can we send as garrison? 140, right here. Canadian Brigade, right? The Canadian Brigade is piss poor in experience and low in morale. Looks kind of ideal, right? Let's just send the damn thing over there. Unfortunately, it takes up some combat engineers, some modern units, but hey, for 135, it seems like a perfect unit to send across. Since everyone is keyed upon Task Force 61 for loading, Task Force 61, let's try to load. Let's say load, where's the Canadian Brigade? Oh, stupid. Infantry. This one here. Do we have enough? No. We don't know. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. So what we're going to do... Okay. All our ships are little ships. Little LSTs and whatnot. These are big ships, but we don't know if they're assault transports or not. We're going to transfer, we're going to grab all the big troop transports from one of the 119. That's sure. Let's just grab a whole bunch, all of them from 119, and switch them with these guys. Be right back. So we're going to grab. So 119 is going to grab this. We're going to go to 119 and grab it back to 161. Where's 119? So we're going to grab some stuff back from 61. Oops, let's just grab it from 61. Where's 61? 63, 61. Let's grab the little ones. Oh, let's grab these guys. Six, seven, eight, nine. Look how slowly it clicks. 10, 11, 12. So we're leaving them some supply ships as well on 61 that can load who knows what's going to be required. Okay, so 61 here. Please God, let it all load. Please God, let it all load. Please God, let it all load. No stragglers, no crap. No stragglers, no crap. No stragglers, no crap. Do not load anything else. Let's verify. Okay, let's hope it works, right? How stupid is that we have to worry about it? Once you've loaded, let's go to Okinawa. Set routing. We're going to go right through the middle. Right down through the middle. Wait, what happened here? Where's 61? Oh, God. Okay. There's the routing. We're going to run right over this island, Tanegashima, right across and over. Please, fingers crossed, let it work. Let it work. All the other units, even though it takes another day, we're going to unpack them and send them on to, we're going to march them out to Kagoshima and up to the war. That's another 6,000 or 7,000 assault value we have here, plus a god-awful amount of engineers, thank goodness. There wasn't much action up at Kurume, but we did lose some pilots here, so we need to fill them up. At Fukuoka, the headquarters is about to seal them in. We moved 30 first day, we'll probably move 30 the next day. See the little arrow here? The enemy is running southwesterly, trying to intercept this headquarters. But we're going to be out of here by the time. We're going to cut off this hex size. Even if the AI shows up here, he's got to move up here in order to open up the hex side again. I don't know if they will. I think it will come out, but it won't come. It will come out, but it won't come up. So we've got a turn or two to destroy everything in this hex. We've arrived. The supplies have arrived at Fukuoka. Let's recombine. And even though these poor bastards are going to be short a little bit on supply, they might have a penalty. But better to have some, only a smaller penalty, than to have everyone suffer that penalty. So these units, I think we'll suffer some kind of penalty for attacking with insufficient supply, but I don't want to wait another day to attack. So everybody attack. Oop, let's make sure there aren't any engineers. Headquarters, no. Artillery, yes. Everyone attack. 17,000 in the attack. I hope I'm not just missing it here. I don't see an arrow coming from these units, which is... I'm awfully weak behind here. I'm awfully weak. He could capture the base if he decided to come out. But right now, I'm just taking that risk. Crush one unit at a time. One enemy at a time. There was not a lot of activity. There's 76 fighters, enemy aircraft destroyed for our 9. But we only lost 5, so I don't have a lot to add to these. The two carrier battle groups have arrived one day behind, or one day late. Where all I'm going to do is I'm going to order them to this hex. We're just going to wait for them to come over. We're just going to sit offshore, offering a target. If the AI wants to attack something, attack us. Hopefully. Hahajima, we just started construction and we got 3%. So maybe we'll get to a level 2 in a month. Maybe. We're burning up supplies. Well, we might as well. Cruisers. Okay, there's nothing happening on Iwo Jima. Just waiting for repairs on Pagan. Are they done? Not yet. God, who sorts it like this, for God's sakes? Quiet on Guam. In Hawaii, the transports are still finishing off. Gonna take a while. Hokkaido is only getting 1,000 a day, so at least 2 more days before we can get out of here. The other tenders have left, heading for Hahajima. If we're going to be building the base up there, we're going to be needing quite a bit more supplies. Nothing at Los Angeles. Oh boy, no, nothing, no reinforcement in San Francisco. Nothing to load. Before we run the turn, I just wanted to show how much disruption this unit came from, this one. Came from the United States and was sitting on those ships so long, it ate up 45 points of disruption just sitting there, because it's been over a month, I think. Gunnel launches 2 torpedoes and kills a submarine. Good job. Oh, Cusk fires 2 torpedoes, kills another one. From 2 misses to 2 hits in one night. That's great. Air raid task force at Naha. Betty's attack, two are destroyed. Ere Kagoshima, nine Peggy's in, three are destroyed. Oh, he got it, one of the night fighters. Bastard. They don't make those anymore. Air raid Kagoshima, 7 Francis, 2 shot down. That's a pretty light amount of strike activity in the morning. Fairly light. Air raid task force at Kanoya, 17 Bettys, 9 are shot down. Air raid task force Naha, Emily's, 2 out of 4 shot down. Karume, under attack by Grace bombers, 12 shot down and 1 Thunderbolt destroyed. Kanoya, under attack by Nels, 2 enemy aircraft shot down. 27 Bettys attack Kanoya, 8 are shot down. No activity on Hajima. Looks like the enemy's given up on us. Japanese bombardment Fukuoka. Pretty not insignificant losses. We take no losses. Deliberate attack. Fukuoka. 17,000 versus 2,000. Fortifications reduced to 5. Look at that. 17,000 to 2,000, and we still can't capture the base. Reduced to 5. Only 2 to 1 odds. 14,000 casualties, and we take 10,000 of our own. Heavy, heavy casualties. I guess we can take a look and see what enemy units are here. Several divisions and the survivors of Kurume. Bayonbong expands. San Fernando expands. Looks like we managed to load and leave. Or maybe we didn't. What the hell is this one still doing here?